want me to stand on this, but I actually don't think y'all need me. Right? Can you still see me with my normal height? I think I'm all right, but thank you for offering that for me.
Again, well, we will be sending y'all a link to the redacted ant video that y'all saw to use for your reporting. So, Superintendent, whenever you're ready, ma'am, get a mic.
Yeah, can everybody get a little closer for me?
Superintendent, whenever you're ready, go ahead.
So I appreciate everybody coming this afternoon, and it's really important that you see that we have the command staff here and members of our Public Integrity Bureau, as well as our force investigative team, to address the video that you just saw of an officer-involved discharge of a firearm during the arrest and the capture of a young man that we're going to give you some information about. The public safety of our city is absolutely paramount, and you know that our number one goal is to reduce violent crime, which has plagued this city, and with a specific focus on crimes involving guns. And this is a particular event that did involve the person whom we arrested was armed, and the event occurred on January 25th. Now, we, by our policy, are releasing the body-worn video of that particular event, but I do need to let you know that the case itself, the full investigation, is not over. Therefore, we can only answer questions to a certain extent, but to the fullest extent that we can, all right? Even though the investigation is still open. So the event occurred, as I said, on the morning of January 25th in the 2nd District. The 2nd District Captain is with us. It's Captain Dupree here to at the end of the line. And it involved a stolen vehicle that 2nd District officers came upon. But that vehicle was indeed occupied by a person later we had learned had just as well been involved in a, or a suspect in a violent crime of aggravated assault. But he was occupying a vehicle. The vehicle was stolen. And that is what brought the attention to the officers, was the fact they came upon a stolen vehicle. When they approached that vehicle, as you saw in the video, clearly, the young man was armed with a weapon. It was in his waistband, easily accessible to him at any moment. I will say at this point, I am incredibly grateful to God Himself that no New Orleans police officer was shot or killed, and that even in this event, fortunately, the young man himself was taken into custody without any injury to him from any kind of gunfire. So these events are so deadly. Anytime a person is armed with a gun, and that is why I am so grateful. And I think that you saw in the video itself the amazing restraint of NOPD in apprehending this young man. The young man was, did indeed, after he was awakened by NOPD, he tried to flee. And he was using his car to back and forth, and he even rammed officers' police cars in his attempt to flee. And during the flight, one of our lieutenants, one of our officers, did discharge his gun 3 times. But after the vehicle became disabled, the armed young man fled from the vehicle through the rear passenger side door, and he was apprehended by 2nd District police officers just a few feet away. We learned afterwards that this young man was 15 years old and armed with a gun. He was transported to Children's Hospital before being booked into the Juvenile Bureau, and he was booked on the following charges: aggravated assault with a motor vehicle upon peace officers, 3 counts of that event; resisting a police officer with force or violence; and possession of a firearm by a juvenile. The members of the Public Integrity Bureau Force Investigation Team were notified of the incident shortly after its occurrence and responded to conduct a use of force investigation, of which both the criminal and the administrative portions are still open. The force investigation team is also investigating allegations of excessive use of force used by officers against the juvenile, which would be normal standard operating procedure that we look at all elements of our arrest. The Independent Police Monitor's Office was on the scene, and the Federal Consent Decree monitoring team was notified. The officer is a 27-year member of the NOPD. And again, according to protocol, he was temporarily reassigned to the desk duty, but he has returned to full duty. Again, all of these are normal protocols. I do want to commend our officers for their hard work and dedication. I also want to commend our force investigation team for conducting a thorough investigation into the officer's weapon discharge. And at this time, I will take a few questions. Thank you.
I'm going to start from my left, number one, for five round of questions, one per outlet. Alyssa, WWL.
Yes, as you watch the video and have gathered information, just your thoughts on how your officers handled the situation.
I will quote you what I heard others when they saw it. It was an amazing amount of restraint that our officers practiced. You saw the video. You yourself saw that gun. You saw how easily it was accessible just by dropping your hand and pulling it out. So it was an incredible amount of restraint, plus the car being used to try to ram. So obviously very high risk, and I was very pleased with the restraint of our officers.
There have been a number of incidents in neighboring jurisdictions regarding suspects who flee in vehicles and are fired upon by officers. Is there anything in NOPD policy that specifically addresses that use of force in a scenario where a suspect is fleeing or using a vehicle aggressively?
You know our policies, and so they're available for anyone to see, but that's a part of our investigation. We look at everything. We look at everything from tactics to policy. We also take each and every event and we go, what could we have done better? And what did we do well? So that's just going to be a real encompassing review. We're not at that, because all investigations need to run its entire course before I will ever comment on whether or not a shooting discharge is in policy or out of policy. That's due process. And every officer is due the full rights of an investigation. So it's too early to say, but I think you can also see from the video the level of restraint. I'm speaking to what I can to this extent. You know, I don't have the dates. 15 years old, I don't know how many years, or if that is even within a short period of time, but 46 events prior to this evening, that's amazing in and of itself, even if you're only 15 years old.
And was the gun stolen as well?
That I don't know, and I don't know that we would even be able to say that now in the investigation, but I don't know that.
So if you could talk a little bit more about the crimes that he committed.
You know, I will actually turn it over to Chief Sanchez to see if you can, feel free to, or anybody else in the FIT team, if you think.
Yeah, we can't comment on those 46 crimes, but that vehicle was used in the aggravated assault earlier that evening.
And it was committed by the 15-year-old, correct?
As far as we know, as far as we know. We can't really talk about it at this point.
And how long was the officer placed on administrative
duty? Yes. So normal procedures is about 3 to 4 days. That's not a decision. We can't speak on that at this point.
Okay, we're going to have to wrap up, y'all. Thank you very much. We appreciate your time.
Thank you.
If you have any other questions, we can give us offline and see if we can.